Welcome to the second part of my travel video from Ukraine. In the last episode, I arrived in Odesa and visited some volunteers together with my new friend Alex. Today, I will follow him and his team as they are patrolling the city at night. We will also visit a shelter during an incoming missile threat.
Coming to our region.
Not afraid?
Sure.
But before we dive into that, I had to explore Odesa's coastline. This city is well known for its beautiful beaches. The beaches have been closed since the start of the invasion. It's been forbidden to swim due to the danger of sea mines floating to the surface and causing harm to people. Anti-mine nets are now in place to ensure the safety of swimmers, and the beaches are officially open again. So I headed for a swim. However, it wasn't the most relaxing experience. The water temperature was nice, but I didn't enjoy dodging the massive jellyfish that was scattered all over the beach. I ran into two other YouTubers making a story about the beach, Johnny FD and Wayfarer Nick. We met this badass cat and then we had some lunch together.
I think this cat is chilling. No cage in the world.
Oh, look at this, guys.
Then it was time for me to head back to the city. I really enjoyed relaxing for a bit since I had been driving for 3 days straight and my first day here was pretty intense. On my way back, I stopped for some groceries when a Ukrainian volunteer overheard me struggling at the cashier. Yuri kindly offered to show me his volunteering headquarters and meet with his boss Mark. He is a political activist, volunteer and author. His son is currently fighting in the war.
The organization to 2019 was one of the biggest in Odessa.
Тогда, наверное, сделаем сейчас так. Зайдем, я там покажу офис.
Office is famous, this great history.
Этот офис, можно сказать, историческое место в Одессе, потому что это был первый штаб сопротивлению в 2014 году, весной 2014 года, сопротивлению русской весне и агрессии Путина. Вот здесь были тысячи людей через этот штаб проходили, и после этого этот штаб остается волонтерским и таким организационным центром сопротивления уже 9-й год. Здесь мы видим наши
флаги Чеченской Республики.
Здесь у нас работают люди, тут наши грамоты, награды, которые получают на наши волонтеры, благодарности. Здесь наши погибшие, к сожалению, доска памяти погибших. Ну вот так вот в целом. Там внизу есть еще подвал, где мы храним всякие запасы, припасы. Ну, в подвал мы, наверное, спускаться же не будем.
There was also underground for volunteers materials and.
Хочу передать нашим шведским друзьям большое дякую за допомогу и Фриде книжки, которые мы сделали.
Freedom against slavery.
Present. Это вот эта книга, это историческое исследование, почему Украина не Россия, чем отличается Украина и Россия, сделано нашими одесскими учеными. Я ее профинансировал, это мой проект. А это моя книга про весну 2014 года, как мы сопротивлялись этому вторжению. Вот. It's present for you. Ну все, пока.
Grateful for the books I received. I gave away the backpacks I brought from Sweden to Mark's organization.
У нас только одни деньги. Дуже дякуємо Фріді за допомогу. Да. Надіємося, що допомоги буде ще більше. Це дуже потрібно нашим хлопцям, які воюють. Дуже дякуємо. Слава шведському народу!
God save the Queen! And Koenig.
And Konung. Vikingi.
Fast forwarding to the evening. I'm now with Alex again.
So what are we doing tonight?
patrolling. Let's check the streets. Let's check if everything is okay in the night in our lovely city. Before the curfew begins, we help to close some bars, restaurants who violating. There is the order in Odessa that all the restaurants, cafe and bars, they should be closed at 11 o'clock. But some of them, they violate and they work after 11. Also, we have a rule that alcohol, it's prohibited to sell alcohol after 10 o'clock. These bars and restaurants, remind them that they have to be closed.
The war still goes on every day, but thanks to the defenders, nowadays the people can be allowed to relax in town with their friends. The closer you are to the front, the earlier the curfew begins.
Here, this one, it's the special force which supports to the police. To the midnight, they still have like 20-25 minutes and they drink coffee because they have to stay until 5 o'clock in the morning. The light will be off. Oh, see? And check the streets now. See, no lights. No lights in the streets. We give like 10-15 minutes more after the midnight because some of the people they really late from their duty or somewhere, and then we begin to check the people, like if they're allowed or not, because some of the people they have special like special tickets, how to say, the bakeries. They bake their bread in the night, so, and the drivers, they have to drive the cars in the night.
When did they start with the curfew? Like, was it close to the beginning of the war? Or
yeah, like a yeah. few days after beginning.
Okay.
Yeah.
After shutting down the bars and restaurants, the team starts to check passing cars, see that they have the right documents, and to check if there is any suspicious behavior.
Sounds not really too late now, and they really have wedding, so they will let them go. Military. Now we're going to pick up the cars and we will move. Uh-oh. Like homeless guy, like some of them we know already, and makes no sense to stop them. They are not dangerous. They're just looking for some food. One more. It's red, we stop. It's green, we go. But not always. If we really need to go, we don't care about the color. Yeah, if something serious and you need to join another team, go fast. Alarm now. Ракета небезпечна. see one of the shelters?
Yeah, I haven't seen one yet.
You haven't seen even one yet?
Gravity?
Yes.
Onyx? Onyx is бывает у нас.
Onyx, the rockets, kind of Onyx coming to our region. Она еще ни одного укрытия у нас не видела, поэтому можно поехать смело показать.
Сейчас подожди.
See, it's written the whole ship. It's like a shelter here.
Kids table.
Sounds like there's people hiding in that rocket attack. At the end of the corridor we have there another way to escape. For example, if this door is blocked, we have always the second door to escape from there. Not afraid?
Sure.
In the alarm, we don't stop the people. And then even opposite, if they need help, we help them to get to the shelter and to show where the shelter is, because not everybody knows. So when it's three short, it means that it's over. So everything's okay. And the people can go back now, see? Some of them, they fall asleep if the alarm is too long, and they wake up in the morning and going back. But some of them, they still sitting, waiting, they can't sleep. And now you can see that they're going back to the apartments. We have not only the rockets coming, but the drones as well, like Shahed. And our air defense guys, they're working, they try to shoot them, so it's too fucking noisy in the city in the night, so you can't sleep.
When the situation calmed down after the missile threat, the team decided to have a break. Luckily, the bakery was open, so it was a perfect opportunity for tea and pastry. Or fika, as we say in Sweden. Reflecting on the experience, I feel so honored to have documented such a unique situation. Alex offered me a ride back to my hotel before continuing patrolling with the rest of the team for a few more hours. In the next episode, I reunite with Nick again and we are going to war-torn Kherson. Over there, we will meet up with Alex again and he will show me something really cool. A mobile dentist clinic inside a military truck. Additionally, I'll have the chance to hold a gun for the first time in my life.